Hey guys, we're back with Let's Talk Movies. I'm Pamodi Kalakota and
I'm Resha Manapirma.
Hi Resha.
Hi Pamodi, long time no see.
I know. Oh, I missed you.
I missed you too. Okay, let's keep going.
Okay. So let's first of all, we want to apologize for the last 2 weeks, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, we planned something really big, but there were technical issues and we couldn't upload the video. We apologize if you listen to us continuously. But today, we're doing something even more greater. We're doing a review, but it's not a movie review. We're doing something else. What are we doing, Irisha?
We're doing one of the most talked series on Netflix this year, which is The Squid Game.
Okay. So, first of all, give us an idea about this game. And also, why is it called Squid Game?
Well, actually, the Squid Game is a real game which was played in South Korea, according to what I've seen in Google. It was actually played in South Korea in about 1980s, 1990s at that time. So according to the series, Squid Game is the last game played out of the six games that they have. And that's what a series is based on. So they have to play
six games. So they have six games.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so what's the first game?
The first game is Red Light, Green Light. Well, actually, as it sounds, when they say red light, we have to stay still. And when the green light is when you can move, actually. But so Squid Game is really freaky. I'm going to say you actually get eliminated in the game. You actually get eliminated, which means you die in the game if you lose the game.
Okay. So basically, literally, you get eliminated.
Yes.
Okay. Well, that's kind of creepy, isn't it?
Yeah.
So the game is very simple, isn't it? The game is somewhat similar to 1, 2, 3 Bumblebee?
Yes, in Sri Lanka, it's similar to 1, 2, 3 Bumblebee.
Oh, like the tomato on my head, that game?
Okay, yeah. So it's like we have to stay still and we have to move
when it's
given. Yeah. And the next game, the second game was Honeycomb, where the players were given small plates of honeycomb. What do you call that?
I think that's actually a candy that they eat when they were children in South Korea. It's very common that it's like a toffee kind of thing made by honey.
Yeah. So they have given shapes. Well, actually, the players are given to select the shape that they want. So none of them were forced. So there is the triangle, the circle, the umbrella, and the star. So the players can choose one.
Imagine getting the umbrella. It's so difficult, right?
Well, actually, the main character chooses an umbrella.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I know. It's like
I was just thinking my dumb head would actually literally pick the umbrella because I like umbrellas. I like the shape. I would probably get eliminated.
Well, actually, that's how the game is. None of them forces us to choose one. So it's your own choice. So according to the game, you have to carve out within 10 minutes the time they give you the shape out of the plate that they give you. And the third one is very common in Sri Lanka, which is played in the Aurudu season, which is tug of war. But literally, the opposite team that loses dies. That's the only thing. Actually, they play it on a bridge kind of thing. And when they get dragged, they go down. They cut the rope. So, so the entire team goes down. The losing team.
Well, this is kind of creepy, isn't it? So, because the pictures, when I got like a small glimpse of things, and the walls and the decorations are very colorful, all the like pastel colors and everything. And even the games are children games. But what happens here is die, basically, right? You literally die.
That's
the idea is kind of creepy, isn't it?
It is. That's why it's a masterpiece. No one would have ever think this could ever.
Definitely.
And so talking about the fourth game, it's
called
the marble game, where they don't exactly tell you what to play. They just give, you have to play it in pairs. So tug of war is played as teams, and then the marble game is played as pairs, where you have to choose your partner. You can choose whoever you want to. And each one of the players is given 10 marbles. So at the end of the time, only one can win, which means to win, he or she has to get 20 marbles with him. That means he has to take the opposite person's marbles as well, in whatever the way. Maybe they play a game or not, maybe they can just take it without violence sometimes. Yeah. So the fourth one is the marble game. And the fifth game is, it's really, really, because I'm afraid of heights a lot, and I really felt that. So in a bridge, so you have a bridge, like, you know, when you say a bridge, it's so high. And yeah, so one side you have, there's the tempered glass, and the other side you've got the normal glass. So you can only survive when you jump onto the tempered glass, right? So if you actually fall on the normal glass, you go down. Called the glass bridge game.
But a tempered glass and then a normal glass, right?
Yeah.
So you have to jump to the tempered one.
Yeah. So you have to jump, and you have no idea. There's no pattern as well. So the people are trying to figure out the pattern.
Okay. So what happens when you fall into the normal glass?
Then you die. You fall, the normal glass breaks and die.
Right.
So the last person who comes get the chance to survive.
Right. Oh my God. Okay. This is serious. Okay. Squid Game. Yeah, the last one.
Yeah, the last one is the Squid Game. Well, the rule is, so the shape that you draw in the ground looks like a squid. That's why it's called the Squid Game, right? So the rules are simple. So whoever the players who play are divided into two groups, the offense and the defense. So you can use whatever they want. So according to the series, they put a toss and they choose whether the offense and the defense. Once the game starts, so the people who are outside only can hop on with one leg, but the people who are inside can walk. But if the people who are outside can cross this neck of the squid, they get a chance to stay on two legs.
Okay.
And then
is it like the hardest game?
Squid it
game.
Is the hardest game.
Should we get on with the second question?
Yeah.
Okay. So my second question is, who chooses these people? Do they decide to go? Do they willingly go? Or were they forced into the game?
Well, actually, the common thing about the players is that every one of them are having financial issues in their families because they don't have money. So I think the people who are planning the game have done a background search on the people that they're going to choose for the game. And they send some person kind of like a marketing person to you, and they play a small game with this poor person. And just think about like rock, paper, scissors. It's actually not rock, paper, scissors, but something, a really small game. So the one who loses have to pay money to the winning person. Okay?
Okay, okay.
So just think that I'm the poor person and I lose and I don't have money to pay back. So, but the guy says, you don't have to pay me money. I can give you a slap.
Okay.
So they give you a slap instead of a comprehensive. But if I win, I get the money.
Okay, okay.
And at the end of the game, they give you a card of the Squid Game. Okay. They give you a card telling you you can play a game and earn money. It's just only a few spots left. Yeah. So that's how they... Like, they don't, drag you into the game. It's ultimately your choice to make.
Right. So, basically, if people complain, they can wipe their hands saying, this is your decision, not ours.
Yeah, exactly. That's the decision. But they choose the perfect people because none of them don't have money, right? So, they obviously try to make some money in an easy way, like playing a game. So, even if I get a chance, I would literally go because they don't give us details about dying in
the game. So I have an idea. So this is, they say, if you can't pay me, I can slap you, right? So that's like a small idea of physical torture. And they might think, well, this is not a big deal. It's just a slap.
Yeah,
and
exactly. They might apply
thinking that it doesn't get that severe to the level where you actually die, right?
Yeah, that's the strategy that they use to drag people into this.
Right. And the main thing basically is about financial issues, isn't it? Like, they're going, they're that desperate.
Yeah.
People
who are not desperate even likes to earn money without that much bigger deal, right?
So basically capitalism, isn't it?
Yeah, basically that.
So I have a theory. This is, I don't know, since I haven't watched it, but this is it kind of similar to Parasite? Because both, even Parasite kind of mostly talk about capitalism and, you know, poverty, class struggles and everything. Even here, about money and how desperate we are to earn some money, some amount of money that we're risking our, literally our lives, isn't it?
Yeah, you could say that, but it's far more beyond. But the theory is kind of like the same. The idea that's given, it's poverty, like the rich controlling the poor.
Right.
And in kind of similar to Parasite, but it's far more than Parasite.
Okay, so, I mean, this is a contest, right?
Yeah, it is. Like, only out of, right, out of 456, only one goes alive out of the game. So entire 455 people die.
Wait, is
just
it like
think, just think about this, like, so what is the value of money? Like, even like, I survive, I am the only last person. That's how you feel at the end. I don't think I can able to use that money, thinking that
so many people die in front of your eyes, right? Wow, that's interesting. I'm actually invested. I'm fully invested.
You should be. It deserves all the love.
Right. Okay, well, so what do you think about, you know, directing and like cinematography and acting, basically? Because this TV series is like really hyping up even now. It's the basically the trend now. Why do you think that everyone talks about it? Do you really think that it deserves this much appreciation, this much recognition?
Yeah, actually, Squid Game was planned like 10, 11 years ago.
Oh,
actually,
really?
Around 2009, 2008, they have planned about this, creating a survival game in Korea, you know, directing something like this, and directed by Hwang Dong-hyuk, who is a recognized director. And I'm going to say he did a great job. Can you think this masterpiece released out of the hands of this person? Hwang Dong-hyuk. I watched a few of the behind the scenes, and they don't use a lot of CGI, but many of the set was real. The places were real. And when they created the series, they tried to give the actors that same feeling that they're doing the survival game for real. Like when I watched the glass bridge scene, that they actually built the glass bridge keeping some height level, where you actually feel that it's higher and you feel the ground below you.
So you're afraid of heights, right? You would have been dead scared.
Yeah. So actually, that's better. I'm gonna say that the emotions are real out of the actors and actresses.
To an certain extent, you actually get scared.
Yeah, so it was brilliant. You should check out the behind the scenes, actually. Awesome.
Okay, I should definitely watch this before. I'm fully invested now. The storyline is brilliant, I think. And I'm definitely going to download tomorrow.
Yeah, you should watch. So I need to say the actors' names. Lee Jung-jae, Park Hye-soo, Jang Ho-yeon, Lee Ha-jun. They are the main actors. And many famous actors like Gong Yoo and Lee Byung-hyun. Well, this is actually a series that you have to watch, definitely. Anyway, this was a turning point in South Korea, I'm going to say. The day since it was released, a trend was created on Facebook. Like, I didn't even know, but I just searched for it. That's when I found out.
Yeah, same. I was like, wait, what's this Squid Game? It's basically everywhere. Like, they're doing makeovers and the clothes and everything. And also that Kokoma thing. Okay, so I'm definitely going to watch this. And I hope that the listeners will definitely watch this as well, right? We hope that the review was good as well.
So guys, if you have already watched the series, make sure to comment on what do you think about the series.
Yes. If you like the video, you can click the like button. And if you want us to talk about something else, you can recommend. You can comment down below. And yeah, we hope to talk to you guys next week, right, Nirasha?
Exactly. We're going to come up with a great series or a movie.
Okay. So guys,
that's up for today.
Yes.
So guys, stay safe and be healthy. Wear a mask. Bye guys. Love you.
Wear a mask. Bye guys.